People love visiting our area to enjoy all the beauty Tennessee has to offer.
Tonight, News Channel 9's Beth Newhoff takes us to a place where friends live the good life, enjoying that beauty from within.
Now I have a backup light,
Okay. All right.
All right, we're ready to go in.
All right.
So what's the best time to go in, head first?
Yeah. Southeast Tennessee is home to spectacular caves. Groups come from all over the world to explore them. Kim Smith talks about the spiritual connection she feels.
And what I get from, like, just stepping inside of a cave is the exact same thing that I get from yoga and meditation. And that's profound, just to feel the of the cave. And the more you go in, the deeper you get, the more you feel it. And I think that's part of the I have to come back every weekend thing.
Most avid cavers belong to a grotto. It's the safest way to explore the unknown, and they'll always have your back.
Yeah, you have to have people teach you, and that's what the function of the grotto is.
Use your hands.
Have contact on the ground
at all times.
Caving is really a lesson in respect, being good stewards of a delicate and unique environment.
Look at this, how fragile this stuff is. Do you see?
Some of this is almost paper thin.
Paige Ashrell is an experienced caver, but he still feels a sense of wonder around every corner.
Yeah, how do they grow straight out?
Quite often you do a climb or a crawl and there's nothing there. But when you do and you come up and there's a huge cavern or passage there, there's few feelings in the world like that when you really find something unique.
And there's potential of, you know, walking around on the side of the mountain, finding a hole in the ground, digging it open, and being the first person to explore something new that, you know, is new to everybody else in the world, and you're the first person to see it.
Wow.
You look at the world differently when you see it from the inside out.
Crawl on, guys.
Cavers like to push the passage, but conservation, always first on the list.
So if there weren't all these formations, we would call this a pancake squeeze, and we just kind of scoot our way through a passage like that. Since there are so many formations, we would definitely not push this passage, but you never know what's on the other side of it.
Apparently, small cavers are an asset to bring along.
See how dark it really is?
And what about those who might want to solo cave?
Never do that. Solo caving is definitely a bad idea, and nobody should ever do it.
Yeah. Really? No.
Really.
For a worldwide caving community, there's no better way to spend their time exploring and selectively sharing their passion.
Isn't this amazing?
From deep under Chattanooga, I'm Beth Newhoff, living the good life, News Channel 9.
Very cool stuff.
I know, looks fun.
It does. You can learn more about caving and the Chattanooga Grotto.
Just visit newschannel9.com/thegoodlife.